Today, I'm going to show you how to set up a simple render for your Muggo. In the previous sections, we learned how to model the Muggo and apply some basic materials. Now that our Muggo is done being modeled, we can think about
rendering.
To get a preview of what our render will look like, hold Z to bring up the shading pie menu and select Rendered. This will show us what our scene looks like with lighting effects applied. When you do this, your scene might look different, and that's okay. You can check the viewport shading options to see if scene lights and scene world are enabled. For our purposes, we want them both checked. In case you don't have any lights in your scene, let's quickly add a sun. Hit Shift A to bring up the add menu, navigate to lights, and select sun. Then hit numpad 1 to go into front ortho view, select the sun, and hit G to grab it and move it up and to the right. Then take this little grip dot here and drag it onto your Muggo. Now you have a sun in your scene. In case you don't already have a camera, we'll add one of those as well. Hit Shift A to go to the add menu, navigate to camera, and select it. You'll see your camera appear in the 3D viewport, but it's not in the right spot, so hit G to grab it, then Y to move it to the front of your Muggo. Let's rename the camera to Muggo Cam, then make sure that we make that camera active by clicking on this camera icon. Then, with your mouse over the 3D viewport, hit numpad 0 to go into your camera's view. My camera is off kilter, so to be able to position it easily, I'll hit N to bring up the end panel on the right side, navigate to view, then under the lock options, select camera to view. This will lock the camera to your movements in the 3D viewport, making it much easier to get the angle you want. I'll hit N again to close the end panel, then I'll select my Muggo and hit numpad period. This will zoom my camera to the selected object, and since my camera is locked to my view, it'll quickly bring the Muggo into focus. From here, you can move around and find the camera position you like, and once you're happy, hit numpad 0 again to exit the camera view. Next, for a rendering setup, we want to go to the Render Properties tab and make sure our render engine is set to cycles. You can choose between CPU and GPU computation. GPU is usually faster. These are the settings I've used to set up the render. I'll hold Z to switch back to Material Preview, then I'll box select all the pieces of my Muggo, then hit M to add them to a new collection. I'll call the collection Muggo, then hit OK. This just helps me keep them organized in the outliner. Then, with all of the pieces still selected, I'll hit numpad 1 for front ortho view, then G to grab, followed by Z to move on the Z axis, and I'll move the Muggo up until the bottom of its feet are in line with the red X axis. In order to get some nice lighting, I want the Muggo to be standing on a backdrop. To make the backdrop, I'll hit Shift A to open the add menu, navigate to mesh, and select the cube. I'll hit S to scale up the cube until it's fairly large, then I'll go into edit mode, make sure I'm in face select mode, hit A to select all, then hold shift to deselect the back and bottom faces. Then hit X to bring up the deletion menu and select faces. You should be left with just these two. I'll tab back into object mode, select my backdrop, hit G followed by Z to move it up on the Z axis until it's in line with the Muggo's feet. I'll tab back into edit mode, then I'll hit 2 on my keyboard, or this button up here, to go into edge select mode, and I'll select the edge in the middle. I'll hit Ctrl B to bevel this edge and scroll my mouse wheel up to give it some more resolution until maybe 4 segments. Then I'll tab back into object mode, right click the backdrop and select shade smooth by angle. I'll select the backdrop and scale it on the X axis by hitting S followed by X and moving my mouse. Then I'll hit numpad 1 for front orthographic view, hit G to grab the backdrop and move it up to the Muggo's feet. Then I'll go to the materials tab, click the plus button to add a new material slot, add a new material, name it backdrop, and pick a color and a roughness that I like. I'll hold Z and switch back to the rendered preview because I want to add some pretty strong top lighting. So I'll hit Shift A, navigate to lights, and choose area. I'll hit G to grab my light, followed by Z to move it up, then hit S to scale, followed by Y to scale it in the Y direction, like so. Then I'll go to the data properties tab, which looks like a light bulb when you have a light selected, and I'll set the power to 300 watts. Next, I'll duplicate this light a few times until the brightness is close to what I want on the Muggo. I'll select all of the new lights and hit M to add them to a group. I'll call it lights and hit OK. Then I'll massage the lights into position and check what my camera sees by hitting numpad 0. It's still very dark, so I'll hit numpad 0 to leave my camera view, then duplicate the left and rightmost lights, pulling them out a bit farther, and adjusting their angle using the grip dot until it looks OK. I want the backdrop to be a little longer on the ground, so I'll select it, tab into edit mode, hit 2 on my keyboard to go into edge select mode, and then select the furthest edge on the ground, and hit G followed by Y to elongate it on the Y axis, like so. Once again, I'll hit numpad 0 to check what my camera sees. And that's looking okay for now. Our Muggo is a business Muggo, so it should probably have a briefcase. We can make a briefcase by using the exact same techniques you learned while modeling the Muggo, and I'll cover this very quickly since we learned about it in the previous two segments. First, add a cube, then subdivide it 4 times by hitting Ctrl 4, tab into edit mode, hit Shift A to select all, and then Ctrl E and drag to crease the edges. Go to the material tab and apply the same brown coat material to the briefcase. Then in object mode, using grab, scale, and rotate, move the briefcase into position next to the Muggo. For the handle, we can bring in a torus from the add menu, so hit shift A, navigate to mesh, and select torus. Let's hop into edit mode because we only need half of it, hold Z to switch to wireframe preview, and delete the bottom half. Then back in object mode, we can grab, scale, and rotate it into position. Then like we did before, we can create a new material, but this time we want the roughness lower and the metallic up a bit so it looks like metal. To get a little panel on top of the briefcase, select the briefcase, hop into edit mode, then select a rectangle from the top faces of the briefcase, hit shift E to duplicate them and P to separate them. Use the solidify modifier to give it some thickness and apply the metal material to it. Tap back into object mode, select the handle and position it in the center of the panel. Then select the briefcase, panel, and handle together and hit Ctrl J to join them. And that's it. From here on, all I'm doing is tweaking by using all of the techniques we've already covered. I made the light stronger and moved them around a bit, adjusted the position of the camera, and made minor tweaks to the look of the Muggo. I recommend you play around at this part and see what looks good to you, and when you're finally happy with what you see in your camera preview, hit F12 to render. I really hope this series has helped some of you learn the basics of Blender and how you can model some very simple characters. If you learned something from this video or you like the content, you know what to do. Also, feel free to come hang out on Discord, links in the description. All my love goes to my patrons, without whom I could not make these videos. And a huge thanks to the Deuces Club for always sticking around to the end of my videos. If you weren't already in the Deuces Club, you are now. And if you want to join the Deuces Club member list that I pinned to every video, just comment Deuces down below. Alright, that's it for today. I'll be back soon with another vid. Deuces.